Today, I want to talk to you about something that's really important. I want to talk to you about gratitude. I'm going to talk to you about three different things. I'm going to talk to you about what gratitude is. I'm going to talk to you about why I think it's really important that you practice gratitude in your life. And then I'm going to give you one thing that you can take away of how you can get more gratitude into your life. Before I discovered gratitude, I'd be grateful for certain things, like a gift that somebody had given me, or I might be grateful because I might recognise that I'm more fortunate than somebody else, and that might make me feel grateful. But actually, it wasn't until I started practising gratitude as a daily practice and getting into a state of gratitude that my life really started changing for the better. On the very basic level, I'm going to talk to you about an example that I talk to many of my trainees about. So I might be talking to them about gratitude, and the example that I will give is that I hate my fridge. I've got a fridge freezer that I've had for 15 years. I refuse to change it because it's not quite broken enough for me to change it yet, but I will complain about it. And I'll be like, oh, that fridge is too old and the drawers are broken and I really should get another fridge, but because it's a big investment, I'm not doing it yet. When actually, if I flip it round, I'm really grateful that I've got a fridge because 80% of the population in the world don't have one. So why is it so important for us to be grateful? Well, I think it's so important because it changes our state and it means that we have more control over our minds. It means that we can properly demonstrate and practice mindfulness. There is no space for negativity if you're grateful. It just doesn't exist. They don't coexist together in your brain. If you're feeling negative about something, if you're feeling insecure, if you're feeling unhappy, if you're feeling hurt, if you're feeling whatever it might be, flip it with gratitude. Because as soon as you start being grateful for the situations that you're in, grateful for the environments that you live in, grateful for the job that you do, grateful for the relationships that you have, grateful for the circumstances that you experience, you'll be able to experience life through a different lens. And it's so important. It's really good for our well-being. It's really good for the way we conduct ourselves. It's really good for your health, your physical health, your emotional health, your spiritual health. And you will see changes in your life if you can do that. So how do you do this? And this is the takeaway. So I just compel you guys to do a daily gratitude list. And if you've never done a gratitude list before, it's completely alien to you, which it might be. You might be way out of your comfort zone. Then you can start by on day one, just writing one thing that you're grateful for. And then on day two, you add to the list. So by the end of the month, you have between 28 and 31 things that you're grateful for. What you have to do with your gratitude list, however, is every single day, you need to read through that gratitude list. And you need to, if you can, put yourself in the space of feeling grateful when you think about that person or that thing or that circumstance or whatever it is that's on your list. That's how you create the frequency of gratitude. That's how you change your frequency from being one of negativity to positivity. And that's why gratitude is so important. So, you know, if you've got any stories to share about how gratitude has impacted your life and how you've managed to make changes in your life, then please let us know. I'm really, really, really stoked to hear your stories. Please subscribe and share, and I'll see you soon.